Peace and love, everybody. I'm Isaiah IJ Rogers, and today I am back with another video. I want to take the time out to talk about Tony's House of Music. Classic, incredible, brilliant record. That last one that was released in November of 1996. It's only right that I break it down and talk about it. The reason why this album's so near and dear to me, it's like I was born the same year the last Tony's record came out. So I like to think I was destined for greatness in some way when all that dopeness was coming out that same year. AT Aliens, Urban Hang Suite, of course, House of Music. You just had so much dopeness going on that year. Growing up, I've always heard the hits, you know, Thinking of You, Let's Get Down. Of course, Let's Get Down. Growing up and getting older and hearing the entire record, I was so blown away by the musicianship and just the feel of the record, the homage it pays. You know, you hear the influence of Al Green and those early stylistics, Curtis Mayfield-esque sounds, you know, within the music. And it is definitely one of my favorite albums of all time. During this period, even a little bit before House of Music, Raphael Sadiq, Dwayne Wiggins, and Timothy Rowley kind of started to go in their separate ways. Ray, obviously before that album came out, you had him doing his thing with Total, Lady with D'Angelo, and then of course Ask of You becoming a hit on his own individual solo joint. He was already starting to make some noise in that lane. Tim and Dwayne started doing their own thing. So Ray had already recorded a big chunk of what we hear on the album separately, away from Tim and Dwayne. Tim and Dwayne used cats like Jubu, Carl Wheeler, while Ray, on the other hand, was using cats like Tommy Bradford, Kelvin Wooten, who's an incredible producer and a producer that is killing the game right now with folks like Ari Lennox, J. Cole, Masego. The list just goes on and on. And if you don't know about Kelvin Wooten, listen to Take Me. Just listen to what he does on Take Me. Them drums, the bass, the guitar work, perfection. And then, of course, you got the incredible, remarkable Spanky Alford, God rest his soul. So Ray, at that point, was just creating those incredible songs which you hear, like Loving You, Still a Man, Let Me Know. He recorded those joints with those cats. One of the things I love about House of Music is the way it opens. Like, people talk about song runs. The first six songs on House of Music, Thinking of You, Top Notch, Let's Get Down, Till Last Summer, Loving You, Still a Man, that sequence of songs needs to be talked about. Thinking of You opens up, you know, with that Memphis gritty Al Green flavor. Lay my eyes upon your face. Thinking of You is just a beautiful love song. The title itself is self-explanatory. Ray talks about this love that he's laid his eyes on for the first time, and all these feelings and all these things, just all these emotions that he's conveying. And you know, when I heard this album recently and I heard this track, there's something that I really caught that was dope. You know, and I love quartet gospel. Towards the end, Ray really gets in that bag. You know what I'm saying? Because I hear these little inflections where he's like, like, and then he goes on. And everything that crawls around my home. I think he's about to do it here. She's though. Call the police, you see. Like he does it right here. And put out an APB and try to find you, try to find you, baby. You know sometimes I wanna call America's most wanted, cause you must want it in my life. Just gritty gospel all the way. Top notch. You just got the Oakland flavor, just real chill, like you're cruising in a ride late night. Just really cool. And shout out to Kelvin Wooten, who did the drum programming on that as well. Then Let's Get Down, the smash. Shout out to DJ Quick, G1. That song, first of all, man, DJ Quick really deserves his flowers. And I want to talk about him more on this channel, more on this platform, because, man, Quick is one of the greatest and just an innovator. When I heard Warren Campbell talk about how this man gave him all his drum sounds, that's something that a lot of people don't do, you know, because everybody's such a gatekeeper. And he's like, yo, you can't know what keyboard, you can't know what type of drums I use. He gave this man Warren Campbell his drums and said, no, that's cool, because I know you're gonna do your thing with it. You can't use them how I use them, so the world is yours. But Quick is one of the greatest, man, and this song, his rap verse, I just love his voice. I love the verse. Everything about this song is perfection. And shout out to Elijah Baker, who does the Gotta Get My Groove On. Grooving. Like that whole thing. Everything again, man. Just phenomenal. And obviously, this is the track that was done in the studio, right? And Ray immediately went to the car dealership and bought him a new ride, because he just knew it was a hit, and that it was. Then you got Till Last Summer, which is like that stylistics flavor, the sitar, the piano. It is probably, it really is my favorite Dwayne moment. Out of like songs like Annie Mae, Slow Wine, Whatever You Want, Till Last Summer is my favorite Dwayne moment on a Tony's record. Again, the production, man, everything about this song is just lovely. The vocals, even towards the, like, just the harmonies. I gotta play this. This harmonies right here. Yo, Tim. God, I love them. Hold up. God. Yeah, man. Just lovely song. Lovely. Loving You. Ray just goes in that Earth, Wind, and Fire. Maurice Whitebag. Yeah. There's no one else in this world that I would wanna try. That's all Maurice White right there. And then I love this song because it's like he also does pretty much everything from the bass, the drum programming, and then the guitar work, I think with the exception of the piano. I want to say this is probably one of the earliest examples of Ray doing almost everything, showcasing his musicianship. He's killing it here, man. And this, again, just... And also, I gotta mention this because I almost forgot. For the first time, you actually hear Ray say the whole, this world is drunk and the people are mad. So, a little tip for you people that, you know, study musicologists out there. Keep that under your hat. Then, Still a Man, which I gotta say is probably Raphael's, one of his greatest vocal performances ever. And you can hear him singing from a place that you can tell he saw something or he admired somebody and he saw how that person operated when it comes to being a man and handling love in a different way. And I'm pretty sure singing from that place, seeing and experiencing that caused them to sing from that place. Just the musicianship, the production, the drums, the combination between him and Spanky, what Ray is doing on bass and what Spanky is doing on guitars. Like, I could listen to just the first minute of this song nonstop, like this. Like, hear that. Just. God bless Spanky. Just that combination, man, is deadly. And then going back to just the vocal performance, man. The ending. Like, I've heard the ending and almost get moved to tears. The way Ray sings, I'm just gonna let it play, man. Like, just hear the beauty in this. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. I'm still a man. You must know that I'm still a man, baby. That vocal performance, even like, I stopped it there, but just hear what it, I don't know if you gospel. Have you ever loved somebody? You, and I wish he didn't fade it out, because you could hear that. That, like, man, that is one of the greatest songs ever, hands down, period. But the album has some interesting spots. Like, there's some songs that are cool. Another standout to me is Wild Child, man. God bless Greg Adams, Tower of Power. Just that whole influence. Ray and Dwayne go riffing off of each other, going back and forth. Just this beautiful song lyrically and just production-wise. It is everything. But man, that's all I have to say about that album, House of Music. It is one of my favorite albums ever. And I hope that in 2023, we get that Tony's project and we see them rocking on stage again, man. Like, you know, I've seen Ray live solo, and it was one of the most incredible things ever, because Ray was taking risk in front of a crowd like that a lot of people are afraid to do, you know what I'm saying? And I just want to see that with the Tonys, especially as someone who grew up on the Tonys and never got to see that band live, never got to see Mint Condition, you know what I'm saying? Us kids, man, we need it. We want to experience it. So I hope it happens a lot sooner than later. That's all I have to say. Let me know what you think of this record. Until next time, much love to you. Thank you for watching. God bless you. Peace.